Okay, in question 30, what is given to us is figure shows two equilateral triangles with area 9. The intersection of two triangles is a regular hexagon. That means this part is a regular hexagon. Regular hexagon is all sides equal, all angles equal. Now this is happening. So if we take regular hexagon, we see that if we draw the diagonals of regular hexagon, we get equilateral triangles because this angle is equal to this 60, 60, 60, 60. Everywhere it is 60. And therefore, these angles are also 60, 60. Therefore, this is equilateral triangles, right? So regular hexagon, if you create triangulate it, it will give you 6 congruent equilateral triangles. Now, because it is intersection of two triangles becoming a regular hexagon, the bigger triangle, now if I want to construct triangle here, then I have to construct one more equilateral, same size equilateral triangle outside, same size equilateral triangle outside, and same size equilateral triangle. These are small equilateral triangles. These three sides are equal. These three are equal. All these sides are equal. So it is just an observation problem that out of this triangle, one more triangle is kept like this. Two triangles are kept one above the other. And a common part is a regular hexagon. And here, therefore, area of first, second, third, fourth, fifth, sixth equilateral triangle, all areas will be equal. 7, 8, and 9. These are three more in the triangle, and area of triangle is given to be 9. Therefore, area of every equilateral triangle is 1 unit. And therefore, in hexagon, there are 6 equilateral triangles. Therefore, area of this complete star is asked. So these are 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, and 12. So area of complete star is 12. Here we basically need how if we keep putting equilateral triangles one above the other like this, we get rhombus. Then if we keep putting them like this, we get regular hexagon. These are some important things that we should know. And in school, normally we are used to draw such diagram using compass and essentially compass, right? Lotus, like this. So these 6 points that you get out of this construction, which we do in school, these points form regular hexagon because we are not changing the radius and all the distances are equal. Therefore, this is your regular hexagon. And if you draw diagonals of this regular hexagon, they will pass through center of the circle. And therefore, you will come to know that these are 6 triangles which we get, and they are equilateral and congruent. So totally 12 equilateral small congruent triangles are there in this figure. Therefore, area is